One app that we're going to use a lot this semester is Socrative Student here in the upper left-hand corner. So I'm going to open this app. What this app allows me to do is to collect anonymous data from students. And in this case, my room number is 240820. You'll probably have memorized that number by the end of the semester. So all you do when you open Socrative Student is enter our room number and join the room. Socrative will ask you to add your name as soon as the teacher starts an activity. So if I happen to forget to start the quiz or the question, this is what you'll see. But let's say I want to ask you the question, do you think this semester is going to be an outstanding semester? So let's go with a true-false question. True or false, this semester is going to be really outstanding. So I've just launched this question using Socrative. So I'm going to say true. This is going to be an outstanding semester. So I've selected true. Now I have to hit the submit answer button to send that answer in. Once you see this page, you've completed the activity waiting for teacher, you can go ahead and log out. You're done with the assignment. It has been submitted. You don't have to wait for me to actually end the activity. What I have to do on my side is say I'm done giving the activity and I have a finish button. I just poked the finish activity button and now you see Socrative is waiting for me to start another activity. So for example, I could ask a short answer question. So the question might be, what is Dr. Ross's first name? And I'm going to ask Socrative to ask you to provide your name. So now it's asking you to provide your name. Notice this asks for last name first, first name last. So I'm going to follow that format. Please do. It helps me a lot with coordinating names and scores. So there's my name in last name first, comma, first name, done. And then I get presented with the question, what is Dr. Ross's first name? My first name happens to be Joseph or Joe. I submit the answer. And again, I've completed the current activity. It's waiting for the teacher, which basically means that it's waiting for all of the other students in the class to finish. As soon as everybody's finished, I say, oh, everyone's done. So I click a button that says finish on my computer. And that ends the activity. Now we're back to the screen that says we're waiting for another activity. And we'll use Socrative a lot like this during the term for me to collect feedback and also to take quizzes.